wicked shall cease from troubling, and the weary will be at rest. And we will study war no more. You're going to hug your sisters and brother and turn your back, and you ain't got to worry about them sticking a knife in your back. Because everything's going to be pure and real of that. It's going to be love, 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 and glory, glory, glory in the highest. Amen. I would like to say hello and invite you all in again out there who's looking in on us over here at 4240 9th Avenue North, First Missionary Baptist Church, Kingston, where our pastor is, and Pastor T.N. Miller. And we just like to say thank you all for streaming in. And again, I would like to send out our prayers for the Goldsmith family. And I don't know if y'all, a lot of y'all remember the King family used to come and sit back there. They were feeling lies. I eulogized him yesterday. And oh, what a glorious time. And I tell you what, y'all, we have come way between these four walls. And they're having a lot of funerals at their cemetery right now. And I do believe that God is trying to give us a closer look. A closer look at what he's saying. See, when you're out there in the cemetery, you can't walk down in these pews and these lavatories and everything else and fall asleep on the word of God. God got us where he have brought us out there. Well, we can't do nothing but stand up and just listen at the word of God and look around you and see all the tombstones out there. And it lets you know that life is real. And I just like to say, more love and more peace to the King family. This is a guy who I went and seen at the hospital. I kind of stood by the family as we went along the way. And I got to tell the Pastor Miller, I never seen a man laying up on the bed. What a wonder in his stomach, a glass wonder in his stomach where you could see all his intestines. And this man toiled and went through this for 15 years. This man was hurt. But God called him on home and gave him that rest. We got so much to be thankful for in here. See, how that could have been the other way around. So I encourage you, whenever you go see somebody in the hospital, even on their sick bed at home, what I want you to do, I want you to look down at them and put your face on them. And it will tell you how they need you and how they need to be loved. Because if you could just imagine being in their spot, you'll treat them more better. Because ain't none of us exempt from going through. Our scripture will be taken from the book of Matthew, the 12th chapter. Let's go to that 33rd to the 40th verse. I'm going to give you a little chance to get there because some of us got our Bible flipping, others got cell phones. And I want you to be able to follow along as I read. Matthew, the 12th chapter, the 33rd to the 40th verse. So good to see all of y'all. And I don't mean that lightly. God is a good God. And it reads, either make the tree good and its fruit good, or else make the tree corrupt and its fruit corrupt. For the tree is known by its fruit. O generation of vipers, how can ye being evil speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart the mouth speaks. A good man out of the good treasure of his heart bringeth forth good things, and an evil man out of the evil treasure bringeth forth evil things. But I say unto you, that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give an account thereof in the day of the judgment. For by thy word thou shalt be justified, and by thy word thou shalt be condemned. Then certain of the scribes and the Pharisees answered, saying, Master, we will see a sign from thee. But he answered and said unto them, an evil and adulterous generation seeketh after a sign, and there shall be no sign given to it, but the sign of the prophet Jonah. For as Jonah was 3 days unites in the way of belly, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. The word of God to the people of God. Let us go to the throne of grace.
Thank you. Yeah, I ain't going.
Amen.
In the book of Hebrews, the 10th chapter, and just one verse, verse 23. Hebrews 10th chapter, verse 23. And the writer says these words, "Let us hold fast the profession of our what? Without Let us do that again. Let us hold fast the profession of our what?
Faith.
Without what?
Faith.
For he is faithful that what?
Christ.
You may take your seat.
Yeah.
I want to talk about, and it's in here, I don't feel no ways. Nobody told me that the road would be easy. But I don't believe he brought us this far to leave us. Let me tell you about this word faith. And I need you to hear me, please. Please let this soak in. Without faith, it is impossible to please him.
Stop!
in the midst of the storm.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I just said, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like an eagle. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk.
Thank you. He is free.